So I did it. I was able to spend 2 hours drawing portraits each day for 101 days. It has been hard, but I haven't given up. Do you want to see the results? Well, before that, let's rewind a little. In case you haven't seen my first video about this drawing challenge, just over 3 months ago, I decided to take my drawing skills to the next level, and I wanted to do it in just 30 days. For this, I designed a plan in which I would spend 2 hours of each of my days drawing portraits. Within these 2 hours, I would make 5 portraits of 15 minutes each, and I would also spend the 45 minutes remaining watching free YouTube tutorials and drawing independent parts of the face, such as the eyes, mouths, noses, and so on. I already have a video about the first 30 days of this challenge on my channel, so here I'll just summarize the result of those first 30 days. Basically, I started drawing like a child of 9 years old, and then I ended up drawing like a child of 11 years old. Good. But since I was still not satisfied with the result, I decided to extend this challenge for another 30 days. But when I got to day 60, I said to myself, well, let's make it to 100 days. But then I said to myself again, is there anything that sounds cooler than the number 100? Yes, number 101. So with that overwhelming logic in mind, I decided to extend the challenge to 101 days. This time, I made a few small changes to my routine. I would still spend 2 hours a day. But instead of drawing 5 portraits of 15 minutes each, I would draw 4. Those 4 15 minutes portraits were mandatory, and I could not get rid of them, not even for a single day. The big difference came in the next hour, where I could choose between drawing 2 30 minutes portraits, spending all the remaining time drawing noses, or watching YouTube tutorials. My choice of what to do in that hour was totally random. Regarding my progress during this 101 days challenge, I have noticed that my bigger progress has been in my first 60 days. Since then, I have felt that my learning curve has been slowing down. Maybe it is because I have saturated myself with so much drawing and I no longer concentrated that much while doing it. Or maybe it is because it is simply the natural process of things. You know, there is always a moment in the development of a skill in which you feel that you are not progressing anymore, although in general you are. It's just that you aren't able to see it yet. This is like losing a kilogram a week, but without a scale that tells you that you are actually progressing. Okay, let's stop talking and see how my progress went. I just can't let you go. Lord knows that I've tried to. You said I was the only one. No one likes being lied to. You made this mess and left me with the pieces. Now I wanna burn all the bridges between us. Well, not bad, isn't it? I still have a lot to improve, but the level of today has nothing to do with what it was 100 days ago. Now I am more precise. My shadows are getting more elaborated and I feel much more efficient at drawing. I am quite happy with the results, and I think it is a challenge worth trying if you feel that you have not improved your drawing skills in a long time. Just hit the turbo and you will see how you can improve too. I will continue this challenge for another 100 days, so don't miss out and subscribe if you want to see my results. See you soon. Bye.